Part of the 93 season at home.
A full house is on hand at Texas Stadium as the Green Bay Packers come to Irving to take on the Dallas Cowboys. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Verne Lundquist along with Dan Fouts at Texas Stadium. Two teams who come in with identical records, 1-2, but such different attitudes, Dan. The Cowboys are almost buoyant because of the return of Emmitt Smith.
And, well, they should be. Jimmy Johnson told us yesterday that as a player, Emmitt Smith is so vital to this football team, but he's also well-respected and liked by his teammates, and we all can remember just how many times that this man has pulled us through.
The Green Bay Packers have lost the last two times out in heartbreaking fashion. How do they overcome that, and how do they win today?
Well, Coach Mike Holmgren told me yesterday, we just got to let it fly. We got to be aggressive on offense. That means getting quarterback Brett Favre out of the pocket, perhaps, and we've got to stretch the defense deep by throwing to Sterling Sharp. But also on defense, look for the Packers to be more aggressive, perhaps blitzing more in passing situations.
It rained overnight in North Texas, and the skies are cloudy. That is why the field is damp. No threat of rain immediately. Temperature in the upper 60s. Corey Harris, number one in the league in kickoff returns, will do that chore now. Nope, it's going to be Darrell Thompson for Green Bay. And he's got some room, a lot more. And here's Eddie Murray, who has to dive down, and Thompson stopped and was touched. Now, there is a flag back on the play.
The flag is going to be offsides against Dallas, Verne, so this return will stand. But what happened, it looked like number 44, Dexter McNabb, tripped up Thompson. That's why you saw Thompson get back up on his feet and run down the field.
Corey Harris leads the league in returns, and that time it was Darrell Thompson, whose back is a personal blocker more often than not. Here's Tom White.
Offsides, number 37 on the kicking team. The penalty is declined. We take the result of the play, first down.
Packers open at their own 45-yard line. Brett Favre, who has been bothered by the blitz the last 2 weeks, expect the Cowboys to come. Second year as a starter now for the Green Bay Packers. First time that Favre has ever played in this stadium. First down from the 45. Sharp is in motion. They hand it off to John Stevens, and he gets a couple. Let's check the Packer offense now. Along with Favre, you've got a front line of Rutgers, Frank Winters, Rich Moran still injured, Campen, Galbraith, and Tootie Robbins. John Stevens and Edgar Bennett both played very well, especially early last week. Sterling Sharp and Mark Clayton are the wide receivers, and Jackie Harris is the tight end. Second down and 8. Ball at the 47. Far short setup, finds his tight end Jackie Harris, and that will be close for the first down at the Cowboy 46-yard line. Ken Norton, the new middle linebacker, makes the stop. For Dallas, it's Haley, Russell Meriden, Casillas, and Tony Talbert. Up front, it's T-O-L-B-E-R-T. Not Tobert. Darren Smith, Ken Norton, and Dixon Edwards are the linebackers. Norton, the new middle linebacker. The secondary, Brown and Everett, Woodson and Kevin Smith. Third and 1. Three tight ends now. West and Chimura join Jackie Harris. That's Chimura in motion. Edgar Bennett moves it across the 45, first and 10, Green Bay.
That excellent return by Darrell Thompson gives Favre and the Packers obviously wonderful field position. And look for Favre and the Packers to be more aggressive with their pass offense. Favre said he wants to use a couple of bootlegs, a couple of waggles, get away from the pressure. But they also know it's vital that they have to force the ball down the field to open things up for their short passing game.
In each of their last two games, they have scored on the opening drive and lost both times. Into the flat, out of the backfield, Edgar Bennett. And he moves it inside the 40 to the 39. Kevin Smith and Dixon Edwards make the tackle.
Talking to Bennett yesterday, he says he's got three roles on this football team. Number one as a runner, number two as a blocker, and number three as a receiver. And he had a wonderful game against the Minnesota Vikings doing all three of those things just a week ago.
second down and 5. No score, opening drive of the ball game. Blitz is threatened. Here comes the blitz, and they try to sweep to the right side. Goblin, John Stevens, the ball carrier, and it's Darren Smith in his first start as a pro, number 59. He played for Jimmy Johnson at Miami, and he makes the tackle.
The sweep is a good call against the blitz, but when you have speed from the left side, we're going to see number 59, Darren Smith, run this play down. Cowboys pride themselves in having great team speed. Smith is just a rookie, but one of the reasons Jimmy Johnson wants him in the lineup is he runs a 4-4-40.
Third and 5, no score. Double tight end set for the Packers now. One running back, that's John Stevens. Sharp to the right side, Clayton to the left. Jackie Harris in motion. No blitz on the line. Sterling Sharp makes the grab in his 84th start for the Green Bay Packers. Last year's leading receiver in the NFL with 108 grabs.
Perhaps the most gifted zone pass receiver, should we say. Look how he finds the hole between all those secondary men. 4 of them converge after the catch, and that's important for the Cowboys because nobody runs better with the ball after the catch than Sterling Sharp.
Second, third down conversion. It's first and 10 at the 27, make it the 28. Not 27-yard line officially. Here's a reverse to Sharp. Casillas just misses him. But then some pursuit catches up. Dixon Edwards, or rather Darren Woodson, made the stop. That's a loss of 5.
That play took too long to develop. By the time that Favre finally handed it off to Sharp, Casillas was in the backfield with great penetration for Sharp deep, and that made an easy play for Woodson to push Sharp out of bounds for that loss of 4.
Second and 14. Stevens the motion man. Favre, left side to Bennett. Winners with a block. Bennett inside the 20 and out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Edgar Bennett, who said he wanted to catch about 70 yards worth of passes today.
Yeah, his ideal day would be 50 rushing and 70 pass receiving and a whole lot of good blocks. Here's a good block here by number 75, Ken Rutgers. He'll run Haley all the way up the field, keep him away from Favre, and create a nice throwing lane so Bennett can see the ball easily and then get all the way down to inside the 15-yard line, almost to the 10.
That's a gain of 20. The Packers have a first and 10, and they can get a first down without the touchdown. Stevens bounced at the 10-yard line.
Yeah, the Packers got the great return by Thompson, and this is another good opening drive for the Packers. They've done this in each of their 3 games. They've got to finish this one off with a touchdown to make it 4 in a row where they've scored on their opening drive.
Mike Holmgren's team won the first game of the year 36-6 over the Rams. Lost to Philadelphia at home on a last-second field goal and did the same last week on the road in Minnesota. Second and 8. No score, opening quarter. Sharp in motion left side. Quick setup into the right flat from Mark Clayton. He had 1 grab last week, none the week before that. He's been almost an absent member of this offense. His new team, of course, he played so many years in Miami.
One thing that all the Packer opponents know is that when Sharp goes in motion, the reason Holmgren's doing that is to get him off the bump and run, to give him more opportunities to catch the ball. That time, Holmgren and Favre changed things up. They put Sharp in motion to the left and threw the quick out to a wide open Mark Clayton to the right.
Third and 2. Bennett and Stevens back in the backfield. They split 2 wide receivers right side. Clock was down to 2 seconds.
And our first example of a bad rule by the NFL, that 40-second clock, costs Favre and Holmgren a very expensive timeout.
9:05 remaining first quarter. Packers on the 3.
Linebacker today, Verne. Ken Norton moves from the weak side to the middle, and it's amazing that the Cowboys just won the Super Bowl a couple of months ago, and they have 3 linebackers in this lineup today that are playing that didn't play in that game in these positions.
And they are now facing a Green Bay team that has a 3rd and 2 and 3. They can make a first down without the touchdown. Jackie Harris in motion. They'll throw it, and it's caught at the goal line. Is it a touchdown? No indication yet. No, no TD, but it's a first down. Woodson made the tackle, but it'll be first and goal, Green Bay.
A quick slant to Sharpie. He just comes right down the middle, and it's a perfect pass by Favre. And great defense by Woodson and Norton, keeping Sterling Sharp inches away from the end zone.
Green Bay scored on its opening drive at home against Philadelphia, opening drive on the road last week at Minnesota. And they are inches away now with four shots at it. Chimura in motion. Edgar Bennett popped up high. Touchdown. Broke the plane. Green Bay leads 6-0.
Packer backs reverse roles that time. That time it was John Stevens lining up at the halfback position, leading Edgar Bennett over the top.
Really an impressive drive to open the game. Good field position established by Darrell Thompson's 42-yard kickoff return. The key play in the drive was a 20-yard screen pass to Edgar Bennett on third down. Here's Chris Jackie, who played high school ball in nearby Richardson, Texas.
Edgar Bennett told us yesterday that being a football player is a lot about attitude, explosion, and sometimes a little bit of height gets you in the end zone.
Packers are up by 7.
The National Football League is sponsored by Oldsmobile. Wendy's old-fashioned hamburgers, the best hamburgers and a whole lot more. Coca-Cola Classic, always the real thing, always Coca-Cola. And by Xerox, the document company.
Well, some of the cheeseheads have found seats here in Texas Stadium. And the Cowboys are down by 7. Here's Chris Jackie's kickoff. Kevin Williams drifts back, and it'll be a touchback come out to the 20-yard line. And the Dallas Cowboys take offense for the first time. Troy Aikman, who had a terrific game week before last in Phoenix, 21 of 27, 2 and A. Newton, Stepnoski, Gogan, and Eric Williams are the offensive line. It's Smith making the start at backfield, in the backfield along with Daryl Johnston. Michael Irvin and Alvin Harper are the wide receivers, and Jay Novacek is the tight end. First down and 10. Are split behind Troy Aikman. Smith gets to the line of scrimmage plus perhaps a half a yard. Packer defense. Matt Brock gets a start for Sean Patterson at right end. Bill Moss at nose. Reggie White at left end. The linebackers are Bryce Pop, Johnny Holland, George Coots, and Wayne Simmons. In the secondary, it's Mitchell and Pryor along with Butler and Buckley. Second down and 9. Pop goes over to the right side, and Daryl Johnston starts in motion. Aikman across the middle, Alvin Harper out to the 35, first down.
So much a part of the Cowboy offense is using motion and formations to uncover receivers. Johnston had already gone in motion to the outside beyond Harper. And look, there's just nobody in front of Harper. Nice throwing lane for Aikman.
Gain of 14 and a first down for 35. Blitz is coming. And Emmett Smith sneaks through left tackle behind Johnston's block and that of Novacek, and then 2 and A was also over there. Detroit with an early lead on Barry Sanders' 20-yard touchdown run. By the way, Emmitt Smith started today 359 yards behind Barry Sanders, but Barry Sanders has a bye week in hand, so.
Yeah, it would be interesting. I mean, if you know one thing about Emmitt Smith, if he's close at the end of the year, he's going to play in that game regardless of the way the outcome might affect the standings. He likes those rushing titles.
Aikman goes deep, caught. Michael Irvin. 61 yards. In this stadium for the first time ever, despite a 14-year career. Most of those years spent with Detroit, and the last time they played at Texas Stadium was in 1977. So Murray tacks on the tying point, but it's Aikman to Irvin for the
timing
TD.
Was exquisite on this play. Verne five steps back, Aikman lets it go, and then the playmaker Michael Irvin takes it the rest of the way. We got a tie ball game.
First quarter, both teams scoring on their opening drives. And the Packers now at their own 32-yard line. Cowboys are stunning Favre with a safety valve pass to Bennett, but he turns it into a first down.
That's one thing Favre's going to see a lot of today from the Cowboys is zone defense. That time very patiently and with real good pass protection. You notice Favre got back real deep and didn't have anybody in his face as he's seen the last couple of weeks. So you don't get anybody in your face, you're going to be 7 out of 7.
Pretty nice start. He had been bothered, Dan, it appeared, so much by the blitz the last 2 weeks.
And it's important for him to get away from the line of scrimmage. And I think Holmgren is cognizant of those problems. And he's a smart coach. He's going to make things as easy as possible for his quarterback.
Charles Haley on Edgar Bennett.
Haley came into the game with a sore right knee, missed practice on Wednesday, but he looks pretty healthy on this one. Great quickness off the ball. Number 94, as he just jumps inside the block or attempted block of tight end Jackie Harris. One thing the Cowboy line will do is they'll slant one way, and if you're not ready for it, no matter how athletic you may be as a blocker or a tight end, it's going to be tough to make a block on a guy like Haley.
Second down and 13. Far, that one is tipped away by Ken Norton. First start as a middle linebacker.
Norton likes the move now to a middle linebacker because he has the opportunity to make plays. He sees Clayton coming, and he just comes right over the top. That's an outstanding play by a middle linebacker, but Norton is used to playing middle linebacker and against the pass offenses because he has to do it so many times in nickel situations.
Those first three linebackers all played under Tom Landry. In 29 years, there were three of them, and here's movement by Rutgers at left end. Favre, this play will come back, and there goes Tom White, the referee. Bodies are falling all over the place, and Frank Winters just took care of Jimmy Jones at the end of the whole play.
And Favre is telling him, hey, man, you got to blow that whistle a little bit louder. I think when White saw the traffic coming out of him, he might have been swallowing this whistle. Trying to wave his hands around, that doesn't help the quarterback any. It looks like, a nice free shot on the official.
Well, Jones got the official, but...
Number 75 offense, 5 yards, still third down.
Tom's breathing a little heavy, isn't he?
The rarefied altitude of Irving, Texas.
You see a guy like Jones coming at you at 285 pounds, and make your heart beat a little faster.
Last time these two teams played was in 1989 at the end of a Cowboy 1-15 season, Jimmy Johnson's first year. Third and 18. Favre, pretty good protection again. Strong arms it for Sharp, and it's incomplete. Thomas Everett was in the vicinity. It'll be fourth down.
Of Good defensive series there for the Cowboys, and that was aided by the offsides penalty against Ken Rutgers. Those third and 18s are hard to convert.
Rutgers, who last week killed Chris Dolman, out of the offensive backfield. Here's the punt by Wagner. Kevin Williams, who's had problems holding on to the football with three fumbles in three games, but he returns this one to the 21-yard line. The second-round draft choice from Miami by way of Dallas. 7-7 ball game, a 53-yard punt, 7 on the Williams return. Time called.
So do you know?
Texas Stadium filled again, as it has been in the last year and a half or so. 65,000-plus on hand in this facility that was built in the early 70s. And the Green Bay Packers coming to town to take on the Dallas Cowboys. This series goes back to 1960. And Green Bay leads overall 10 games to 6, including a couple of NFC championship games. Here's Aikman going left side and finds Michael Irvin in front of Roland Mitchell.
Last time the Cowboys saw Reggie White, he was wearing a green uniform, but it had wings on the helmet. This is the yellow helmet of the Packers, but they know where Reggie is. This time he lined up across from Kevin Gogan down inside, and Packers are still searching for a way to get number 92 more big plays.
That's going to be a fascinating matchup today, Reggie White against Eric Williams. The second time they met last year in regular season, Eric Williams was voted Offensive Player of the Week in the NFL. Here's Michael Irvin, and he almost breaks out of the tackle. As it is, he beats Mitchell to the 39-yard line.
Yeah, it's the post pattern that the Cowboys are so good at. Irvin comes down to the inside, and Aikman will just come back five steps, one, two, three, four, five, and let it rip. Irvin has the body size to shield Mitchell from the ball.
First down and 10, Emmitt Smith to the 35-yard line. Interesting how most folks around the league now talk about these Cowboys, the huge size they've got at wide receiver.
They are the biggest wide receivers in football. And now that Harper's starting to play up to that number one draft pick billing, he really gives them weapons on both sides. But they're always bigger than the guys covering them. They may not be faster, but they get their body in the way. It's almost like playing basketball, dumping the ball into the low post center.
Second down and 8. Aikman, Novacek, first down at the 19.
Last week, Aikman hit 9 in a row to start the ball game. Well, he's 5 in a row so far. And if the pass protection couldn't be any better. Tuane, number 76 at the top of the screen, is going to be working on Matt Brock. And Brock is just a step slow to get to Aikman. And they're just picking apart this Packer defense.
Aikman, 133 yards already on 5 completions. Emmitt Smith hit at the point of the exchange. Bryce Pop, number 95, was right there. Emmitt Smith, of course, signed that contract week before last. Said yesterday in a long conversation with us that he bore no bitterness, but he would never forget. I thought he was somewhat unconvincing when he said he bore no bitterness.
Well, loyalty is such a big part of being an athlete and being a team member, and sometimes an organization and a player don't always see eye to eye on just what loyalty means.
Blitz coming from the outside. Aikman across the middle, and Smith drops it.
And Reggie's telling him, Emmitt, you catch that one, you're spiking that ball in the end zone. There was nobody there. Emmitt had a step, and he stops Aikman's completion string here. Hit him right in the old hands there, and look at even the Green Bay guy was amazed. He was ready to signal touchdown.
Jimmy Johnson will pull Emmitt Smith out of the lineup on third and 10 now. And Derek Gaynor comes in. Kevin Williams is also in as a third wide receiver. Third and eight. First third down of the game for the Cowboys. Aikman. Kevin Williams. And he falls, is tackled short of the first down at the 15-yard line, so we'll see Eddie Murray. Kevin Williams, who was a local lad, he played high school ball at Roosevelt High School in Dallas, and the other NFL player who came from Roosevelt High School played there by the name of John Washington. You knew him by a different name.
He came to San Diego in 1958 as John Jefferson, or J.J., one of the most charismatic players I've ever played with and or ever seen, and did some time in Green Bay as well.
Eddie Murray. Novacek will hold it. It's up and it is good. And Eddie Murray, the longtime Green Bay Packer. Detroit Lions. Why, there's a lot going on here. It's 10-7, Cowboys lead. Corey Harris leads the NFL in kick returns with an average of nearly 32 yards per return. Had a 65-yarder last week. And despite that degree of excellence he's displayed, never in his life has he returned to kickoff for a touchdown. Onside kick. Tried by the Cowboys. Picked up by Dallas. They wanted to make something happen in the kicking game, and they just did. Darren Smith. Jimmy Johnson said yesterday, I think we can make a couple of big plays in the kicking game.
Well, last year, the kicking game, special teams, really jump-started the Cowboys season. So far this year, it's put them in a hole up until this moment. Excellent call by Avezzano and perfect execution by Eddie Murray. Packers had this one on the first bounce, but then Gaynor comes in and drills Marcus Wilson, and it's a big hop to Darren Smith, and the Cowboys get the ball inside the 50. What a play by Gaynor, and a great bounce off this turf to Smith.
First down and 10. Troy Aikman will probably go for a bunch. Pumps, goes deep. Michael Irvin has his man beat, and there's the flag.
Mitchell complaining that Irvin was grabbing him, but Mitchell never looked back for the ball. That's an easy call for the official to make. That's our back judge, Paul Bates, number 22 there. He had the flag out early.
Number 47 defense will be a first down for Dallas, the 9-yard line.
Mitchell never looks back for this ball until it's too late. He made contact. Ball just a little bit underthrown. But Irvin gets the call.
First and goal at the 9. They have victimized Roland Mitchell in the first quarter and first series of the second quarter. Smith stacked up at the 7. Reggie White, number 92.
A lot of the talk this year has been about field goal kicking and how much of an influence that part of special teams has been on the game. But today we saw a 42-yard kickoff return for the Packers to open the day. And then that surprise onside kick by Eddie Murray. So the kickers are getting involved in the NFL.
Yeah, I think back to our conversation with Johnson yesterday. He said, we can make a couple of things happen in the kicking game. I think we both were thinking of returns or blocked punts or such.
Yeah, he didn't say anything about onside kicks.
Especially to open the second quarter. Aikman. Pumps, dives out of bounds at the 1.5.
That's going to be close for a first down. Just too many weapons to defense. But it all starts with great pass protection. Aikman gets a chance to look at the entire field. And smartly tucks it under his arm and gets down real close to the first down.
It will be third and goal. And time has been called. There's the 40-second clock that comes into play again. This time, 3 seconds remaining on the play clock. Aikman calls time. Dallas leads by 3. longer left, the offensive coordinator, Norval Turner, who is among the happiest guys in North Texas with the return of Emmitt Smith.
Well, he has his entire offense to work with, the most potent offense in the NFL right now.
Third and goal from the one. Backs in the eye. Emmitt Smith. And Leroy Butler makes the tackle. It'll be fourth and goal.
I think the Cowboys might have outguessed themselves there, or tried to outsmart themselves, because they tried to go wide to Emmitt Smith. They're only a yard or two away from the end zone. And how many times have we seen Emmitt Smith just following Johnston over the top and into the end zone? Good play by the Packers, keeping their contain on Smith and forcing this field goal attempt.
Eddie Murray on for the second field goal attempt in the ball game. This from 19 yards. Up and good, and the Cowboys use the onside kick and the recovery, plus a 40-yard penalty to set up the field goal. And this is how this drive started after the last field goal.
Yeah, with the left foot here by Murray. Nice big bounce there. Marcus Wilson had it for an instant, and then it's a one-hopper to Darren Smith that set up this field goal by Eddie Murray. And the Cowboys are getting with the swing of things in the NFL in 93. They got two field goals already.
I know how happy that makes you.
I saw you here, Bradshaw, talking about narrowing the goalposts. I said, why don't we just get rid of them altogether? Take the foot out of football and let's, throw it around the lot a little bit.
There's Joe Avezzano you saw urging his special teams on. Joe, who keeps a memento of his days in Corvallis in his office. He's got a 10-gallon hat with Oregon State around it.
And you know he had to be proud of those Beavers yesterday as they upset Arizona State. He's also a 1991 Special Teams Coach of the Year. Got a nice big trophy in his office, too, for that.
And Eddie Murray will kick it deep, we assume, to Corey Harris.
Been the best part of the Packer offense today has been their kickoff returns, both Harris and Thompson.
13-7, 12:55 to go first half. This will be Harris at the 7. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line. Matt Vanderbeek made the stop.
One thing Holmgren told us yesterday is he's got to open up his offense a little bit more and get the ball down the field. Favre had 20 completions last week against Minnesota. 17 were 5 yards or less, and 3 were 10 yards or less. No completions over 10 yards for the Packers. That can't get it done and won't get it done in the NFL.
Mike Holmgren said he would gamble today. He's going to open it up. Favre is 7 of 9. Packers trail by 6, 13-7. Quick setup, left side incomplete. Intended for Mark Clayton.
You know, when you look at those statistics and everything, when Favre first came into the game, they said, well, he doesn't have the touch to throw the short pass. Well, that's all he's been doing the start of this season. He told us yesterday, now people are complaining, hey, he doesn't have the arm to throw the long pass. He can't win.
Tell you who thinks he can is Troy Aikman. They played together at the Pro Bowl, and Troy Aikman said he's got one of the strongest arms he'd seen. Play action. Favre, incomplete. Intended for Bennett, and he had Darren Smith over his back. It'll be third down.
Another example of what Holmgren's going to try to do today is use more play action, try to get Favre in different places of the field to read the defense. We also might see him on some rollouts today and some waggle plays. Try to get him away from that pressure.
That was the backup quarterback Ty Detmer signaling in the plays. Marcus Wilson comes in there on third down. So does Robert Brooks. That's Wilson, number 29. Third and 10. Cowboys bring 4. Favre fires it. And that's a first down out to the 37-yard line. Sterling Sharp with another grab. A gain of 12.
I think fires it is the perfect description of that pass, Verne. Sharp again found a hole in the secondary, and this ball, watch as he turns his head around, this ball is on its way and it's smoking. Knew exactly what he needed for the first down, got a perfect pass, and the Packers moved the chains.
Sterling Sharp, who said he enters every game expecting to catch a minimum of seven. Had seven in each of the first two, five last week. First and ten. Yep, they're going to bring this back. Looked like Sharp had moved across the line out on the left side.
False start. Number 84 offense. 5 yards. Still first down.
That's just lack of concentration by Sharp. The play was designed to go to the other side to Clayton.
Green Bay has, as Dan said a moment ago, their biggest weapon so far has been the kickoff return. Total yards from scrimmage, 76, and most of those on the opening drive. For the third week in a row, they scored a touchdown to open the game, but they trail now 13-7. 11:35 to go first half. That's John Stevens, tackled by Tony Casillas. This Dallas defense under the new coordinator, Butch Davis, had, he told us yesterday, has played fairly well with the exception of the third quarter and part of the fourth in the opening game Monday night in Washington.
And he said that the difference that we'll see with the Cowboys as the season goes along, he feels that they're getting more experience and that he feels more comfortable with them being a pressure-oriented defense, which is one of those coach-speak terms for, we're going to blitz more.
Favre to Bennett. Blockers in front. Bennett to the 43. That's short of the first down. Tackle is made by Darren Woodson. They picked up 11. They needed 15.
Packers are getting pretty good at the screen pass after not calling any for their first 2 weeks of the season. They threw it about six times last week. Bennett was recipient of most of those, and here he is again coming out behind Winters and Galbraith and Campen. That's pretty good when you can get three linemen out in front of your screens.
Third and three. 10:15 to go first half. Cowboys lead 13-7. Favre right side. Marcus Wilson has the catch and a first down at the Cowboy 45-yard line. Tackle made by Kevin Smith. Michael Irvin has the Cowboy touchdown in this game, a 61-yard catch from Troy Aikman.
He already has over 100 yards receiving on just three catches.
First and 10. Green Bay, Colorado, and Atlanta scoreless in the third. And, of course, the Giants play the Dodgers later this afternoon. The Braves and Dodgers tied at the top. NL West. Play action. Favre. Jackie Harris, the tight end, at the 37-yard line. Gain of eight.
It's one of those little bootlegs right there, Verne. After the fake, Favre rolled out and hit his tight end. And that's a nice gain on first down to be able to bring up a second down and short where the defense is really off balance. They don't know whether to expect a run or a pass. It's one of those free down type of plays that a lot of teams will try to go deep on.
Second and two. Bennett makes the catch. That's another first down.
Now they're saying incomplete.
Yeah. He was bobbling it.
Well, the play was made by Dixon Edwards, number 58. Here's Bennett and Edwards. Watch the strip with the right hand. That's perfect timing and a good call. That's in slow motion. It looked like Bennett might have had the ball, but in regular speed, that's bang, bang.
And again, the call was made by Paul Betts. 16 passes and 9 runs so far.
Talked about Holmgren wanting to let it fly. He's let it fly a few times already.
Third and two. 13-7, Cowboys lead. And the officials have called time. Dallas has called time. So that is The Cowboys, second time they've used a timeout. They've got one left. 9:10 to go first half, 13-7 Cowboys. Credit this man for inadvertently helping the negotiations along. After they lost to Buffalo, Charles Haley put his helmet through the wall and said, blankety blank, blankety blank, get Emmitt Smith back in here. Jerry Jones was listening. Here's Sterling Sharp with another grab for a first down at the 35. And there is Emmitt Smith, who told us last night that he watched that Buffalo game from Tallahassee, where he was watching his brother play football at Florida State. And he said he got a big smile out of the fact that Thurman Thomas had number 22 taped to his ankle.
And he also kind of liked the way the crowd was chanting his name, Emmitt, Emmitt. And you know that Haley's well-placed helmet may have had something to do with us seeing Emmitt here today.
First down and 10. Here's the pass to the left. John Stevens down near the 20. Just to round out the story about the aftermath of the loss to Buffalo, they all walked into the locker room, and Haley, who is an explosive personality, slammed his helmet into the wall and broke through. Said with expletives deleted, let's sign Emmitt Smith. And the next item on the agenda was for the team to kneel and say the Lord's Prayer.
You always got to say the Lord's Prayer after a game.
There was something incongruous about it all. I'm not sure how else to put it. Second and one.
Amen.
Here's the blitz. And they got him. Ken Norton.
He was a little reluctant at first to make the move to the middle linebacker position, Vern, but the coach said, as far as the team aspect is concerned, this will fit your personality because you can make plays. And if you make plays, then the individual honors will come. He sidesteps the block and drops Stevens for a big loss.
When he was signed as a second-round draft choice out of UCLA, people referred to him as Ken Norton Jr. Most folks have dropped the junior now. He's earned his own identity. Blitz. And they throw it away. Favre had to get rid of it.
Had to get rid of it because it was a safety blitz by James Washington. And that's usually the blitz adjustment for most offenses, is put the ball up. Packer fans have seen way too much of this, though, with Favre just unloading the ball down the field in the general direction of Sterling Sharp. But Sharp isn't looking for this one. He sees it sail over his head. And a good play and a good call by Dallas and Butch Davis sets up this field goal try.
Chris Jackie, who grew up about 20 miles from the stadium and then played collegiately at the University of Texas at El Paso out of Wagner's Hole. That's got plenty. But it is wide to the right. Not the kind of homecoming he wanted. A very impressive drive goes wide right. It's still 13-7.
That and was trying to avoid it, and he may have overstrided, and that's why the ball never hooked in between the uprights.
Misses from 43. And that's his first miss after 9 in a row for the Green Bay Packers. So that streak comes to an end. Cowboys take over. Aikman play action. They're going to test the right side, and they've got Alvin Harper open. There is also a flag down. Here's Harper at the 9.
Flag is down in the secondary, Vern. But the officials are saying, come on down. It may be against the Packers, and this play will stand.
Contact. Illegal contact. Number 36 defense. Penalty is declined. The result of the play will be a first down and goal.
It's illegal contact against the Packers, and it's going to happen right in the middle of the field. But at the top of the screen, there's the illegal contact. But at the top of the screen is Harper at 6'3", going over the 5'9" Terrell Buckley in a 66-yard gain.
Emmett Smith comes left. But the theme of this first half offensively for Dallas has been let's expose the Green Bay secondary.
They've been exposed already this year. Their only two losses. Randall Cunningham beat them with a touchdown pass. And, of course, who will ever forget Gulliford's catch last week from Jim McMahon? That was just a size mismatch. We talked about the size advantage that the Cowboys have on all the defensive backs in the league, but 5'9 against 6'3, that's just not going to hold up.
Second down and goal from the 7. Smith in motion out of the backfield. Aikman, short setup, finds Irvin at the goal line, and he is stopped just short of the score. That'll officially be a gain of 6.
This was what sets the All-Pros apart from just the rest of the guys playing in the NFL. Catching the ball over the middle, knowing you're going to get tagged. As soon as you do, then the big guys are on their way. Nice job of Buckley that time, standing Irvin up and preventing the touchdown and waiting for help to come.
Michael Irvin, 4 catches, 104 yards. And you see the Green Bay defense inside the 20.
They've only given up 3 touchdowns all year.
Right.
But Johnson and Norv Turner told me yesterday that with Emmett back in the game, a lot of people are going to be concentrating on him, so that will open up our passing game. And it's opening it up in a big way as the Aikmans just bombed the Packers secondary.
Cowboys have to burn a timeout again. That's their 3rd. They are out of timeouts with 5:13 remaining in the first half, and Dallas about to score again. Well, CBS Sports will present exclusive coverage of baseball's postseason. The battles of October begin Tuesday at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. The Toronto Blue Jays go into Chicago to take on the White Sox. Telecast at 8, first pitch at 8:12, then game 1, either San Francisco or Atlanta.
How's that, Verne?
Where did you grow up, Dan?
I'm kind of a Giants fan. What the heck? Let's just say the Giants and Phillies, huh?
All right, it's either the 49ers or Atlanta at Philadelphia on Wednesday night.
I figure I make half the people mad, half the people happy, you know.
Well, the Bay Area just erupted with joy. Colorado and Atlanta in the bottom of the 3rd. No score.
All the Giants have to do is today beat the Dodgers 4 straight on the road, something they haven't done since I think you were born back in 23. And that was at Ebbets Field.
23. That's close. Cowboys have talked it over and back out. They have a 3rd down at the 1. Green Bay has not given up a rushing touchdown this year.
And remember the last time the Cowboys were in this situation, they tried to go wide on a counter play to Emmett Smith. Look for Smith this time to go up over the top.
Smith with 7 carries for 11 yards so far. A 13-7 game. Green Bay opened by going the length of the field following the 42-yard kickoff return. They took a 7-0 lead. Dallas came back on a 61-yard Aikman to Michael Irvin pass. We've since then had 2 Eddie Murray field goals. And now Dallas threatens again. 3rd and goal at the 1. One hopper. Aikman is stopped. They'll have to go for the field goal again.
We talked about the field being wet. Maybe there was a wet spot on that ball because as Aikman turned around to hand it to Smith, it just popped right out of his hand. See the snap? It appears to be a good snap. He's got it in both hands, and then it's just like a banana. Slips right out of his hand, and that's a bad feeling for a quarterback a long way from the end zone. And not much blocking.
And that brings on Eddie Murray for the 3rd time. 19-yard field goal again.
But you notice the call was a deep handoff to Smith up over the top. But the fumble prevented that.
Dale Hellestray is the center. Snaps it back, and Jay Novacek will hold. Eddie Murray is 3 for 3 in his first game at Texas Stadium, and the Cowboys extend their lead to 9 points.
A look behind.
He'll be wearing new prototype leg pads. The Air Armor system adds protection to the lateral thigh and upper shin, while leaving room for the mandatory soft knee pad. The laminate composite shell, air bladder padding system, and support mechanisms combine to permit free, natural, and dynamic movement of the legs, while providing more protection than previously possible.
4:48 to go. Dallas trying to get the record back to 2-2, and Kenneth Gant doing a little cheerleading, number 29. Eddie Murray. Harris at the goal line. Out to the 20. Good special teams tackle by guess who? Billy Bates, number 40. He is something special.
Well, to come back from the type of knee injury he had last year, this is just remarkable. In his 11th year, playing like a first-year man, throwing his body all over the place, making another special teams tackle. And he ought to celebrate. See, that's the difference between him and Gant. Gant celebrates and runs around before the play, and he didn't get anywhere near the tackle. Bates gets in on the tackle. That's when you celebrate.
Corey Harris, who returned the kickoff, was injured on the tackle, so Harris is down at the 20-yard line.
Now looking at his left knee, this is a bad sign. And Harris told us yesterday he was going to get more involved in the offense, perhaps on third down as a receiver. Right in behind the wedge, there comes Bates from the side. And as he hit the ground, it looked like his legs were spread, and that's where the injury occurred.
Harris, who played collegiately at Vanderbilt University, grew up in the Indianapolis area.
He may have been Holmgren's secret weapon, though, as the season develops, because he has experience on offense and is anxious to get back on that side of the ball and involved in the third down passing game.
Corey was an all-purpose player at Vanderbilt, wing back, wide receiver, running back. He gained 1,000 yards. Bright young man who grew up idolizing Eric Dickerson, who played collegiately on this field for SMU. Corey Harris, and hope it's nothing terribly serious. They'll help him out on the bench. First down and 10, Green Bay, 16-7. Favre pumps and goes deep, but there's great coverage by Kevin Smith, and Favre throws it out of bounds. Baseball on the minds of a lot of folks. Let's check in back in New York with Greg.
All right, Vern, in Atlanta's Fulton County Stadium, David Need on the mound for Colorado. That's a Fred McGriff base hit up the middle. It gets Otis Nixon home. Terry Pendleton has also singled a run home in the third inning. It is now a 2-0 Atlanta lead as they look for at least a share of the NL West title today, Vern.
Okay, Greg, I wish you could have seen the frown just cross my partner's face. Not the kind of news he wanted to hear. Here's Corey Harris at second down and 10. Favre finds Clayton running a crossing pattern underneath, and he's out near the 30-yard line. It'll be a half a yard short of the first down. Larry Brown with the tackle. 2-0 Atlanta over Colorado. That's the report that we just had from Greg Gumbel.
A lot of time left, Vern.
But are there enough innings left? See, you see, time is not of the essence.
Not in baseball. It never has been.
Third and one. Darryl Thompson is in. Flag is down. Reels is the field judge, and he's the one who's in.
You know, it's not this complicated a game.
2-0 with the clock. Please reset it to 25 seconds. There is no delay game.
Hate the flag, and I appreciate the fact that Tom White explained why they picked up the flag. That seems not unreasonable to ask officials to do.
Well, that's why we gave microphones, you know, so they could talk to the crowd and talk to us. And that's a good job by Tom White. They hate to admit those errors, though.
Third and one. And that should be enough for a first down for the Green Bay Packers. Edgar Bennett played collegiately at Florida State. We talked last week about the small ironies in football. Well, Edgar Bennett was telling us last night that when he was in the 10th grade at R.E. Lee High School in Jacksonville, he was a cornerback. They were about to play Escambia of Pensacola in the playoffs. Escambia had a running back named Emmett Smith. Edgar Bennett played Emmett Smith for the scout team, gained 400 yards against his own team during the week, and they switched him to running back.
One, two, three flags.
Four. Somebody else on the far side got in the act.
I think that one came out of the stands.
Handkerchief was heavy, and he said.
You know, I think the Cowboys have an argument here. Was this a catchable ball? But when you throw four flags, you're not even going to argue.
Pass interference. Number 37 defense. First down.
But they're trying to get pressure up the middle against Favre, because they've seen him put the ball up for grabs a couple of times. That's a three linebacker blitz that time. And Washington is a little bit too soon with his coverage. That ball was overthrown, but four flags says it's a good call.
13-yard penalty, bootleg. Haley knocks it down. Wow.
Well, he looked like a volleyball player that time, didn't he, Vern? He just swatted. Take that ball back. Favre is lucky he didn't pick this one off. It's a bootleg trying to fool Haley. Been around a little bit too long, gets that big right hand up there and just snuffs that one out.
Charles Haley acquired from the 49ers last year. Second down and 10. 16-7, Dallas leads. Favre, fumble, nope, incomplete pass. Bring it back. Jeff Coat has it, but it's no TD. Haley with the pressure. Tom White with the explanation.
Forward. Third down.
You know, Jeff Coat's run a couple of these back in his career, two of them, hoping this was going to be the third one. Let's see if this is a good call or not. Yeah, that's a good call, because Favre was coming forward, and again, it was a defensive man right in his face that knocked the ball away. Good call by Tom White. That was a forward incomplete pass.
Third down conversions. Green Bay has been excellent thus far. They've got a 10-yard lead now. Three-man rush. Favre, right side for Bennett. Short of the first down, Kevin Smith made the tackle. And the Packers will have to punt.
Well, the Packers are taking care of one problem, and that's giving Favre some pass protection on this play. Number 94 is Haley, lined up on the right side of the field this time. And the Pack finds where he is. Rutgers and Winters do a nice job, and they both get a kind of a cheap shot in there at the end, but why not?
Ryan Wagner will punt it. Kevin Williams waits for it at the 10. And this will be allowed to drop at the 11-yard line. And then down at the 1. Well, punt returns have been a problem for the Cowboys this year.
Well, Williams, you said he has fumbled three times this year, and what happens, you get gun shy, and instead of making the tough catch as that one would have been, you let the ball go, and what that does, that penalizes his team 10 yards. They're going to take over on the 1 or 2 yard line instead of at about the 12.
Joe Avezzano was talking about the problems that Kevin Williams is having yesterday, and he said they fought through the same thing with Kelvin Martin a few years back. They actually replaced Kelvin Martin as a punt returner with Derek Shepard, and then they let Kelvin Martin work his way through it. They think the same thing will happen with Kevin Williams.
They're hoping the same thing happens,
yeah,
with Kevin Williams. He's got the talent.
Cowboys at the 1. They flip it out, caught by Darryl Johnston, and he's out to the 11-yard line. Moose.
Is that what they're... I wouldn't think they would be booing that play. That was a pretty good play.
Oh, that's Moose.
What a great nickname, huh? How's Emmett doing, Vern?
Well, let's see. At the two-minute warning, Emmett Smith, 7 for 11. Open all night. Two-minute warning. First memorable meetings between these two teams took place in the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. Championship game to preserve a 7-point victory and give us one of the lasting images of Tom Landry. And they have met numerous times since. Here's Aikman handing off to Johnson. He's got a first down after the 19-yard line.
Okay, Moose, that's it for you. If we get the ball on the 2-yard line, we'll give you two plays. Bring it all the way out to the 20, and now you go back to being a blocking back. Nice little trap right up the middle here to Johnston.
Keep in mind the Cowboys are out of their timeouts. They had to use all three, so they can't stop it. 90 seconds to go. Dallas is up 16-7 with 1:28 to go first half. Emmitt Smith out to the 30. At 45 yards last week in Phoenix, just to put a period to the story about Edgar Bennett pretending to be Emmitt Smith before that high school quarterfinal game, Escambia and Robert E. Lee. Bennett was telling us that Robert E. Lee held Emmitt Smith to below 100 yards in that game for the only time in his high school career. However, Emmitt Smith's team did win the game. Aikman. Dropped by George Kuntz.
One of the rare sacks of Aikman. He's feeling this one, too. This is a good time to call it. The Cowboys had been ripping him pretty good running the ball. So they're coming on the run blitz, and Kuntz comes right up the middle. And Brock gets in on it, and Bryce Pop adding a few pounds to that sack.
Green Bay calls timeout. They stop the clock with 45 seconds remaining first half. They have one timeout left, and Dallas is facing a second down. That's what is going on there. So the Cowboys get three field goals from Eddie Murray. That's the margin of difference as Jimmy Johnson's team goes into the locker room with a 9-point lead. It's Dallas 16 and the Green Bay Packers 7, halfway through this game at Texas Stadium.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? Miller Lite, great taste, less filling. Can your beer do this? Your Allstate agent for home, auto, life, and business insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate. And by AT&T, we help put your world within reach.
Who grew up in Dallas and wound up playing here. Everson Walls, Michael Downs, Harvey Martin was a third-round draft choice of the Cowboys back in the early 70s. And the latest, who grew up in the shadows of downtown Dallas, Kevin Williams. Yeah. Emmitt Smith across the 50 to the 49-yard line. George Kuntz makes the tackle.
And you know, not to criticize your play-by-play calling today, but Vern, but have you mentioned the name Reggie White yet?
You know what? No.
And that's amazing. Because White has only one tackle on the entire afternoon.
Going against, for the most part today, Eric Williams, who many think will become one of the premier offensive tackles in the game of football. Here's the blitz, and Emmitt Smith darts through it, spins, breaks the tackle, and draws the applause of the crowd.
That's just like old times, though. Up in the hole, breaking a tackle, spinning away, diving forward. And they're going right at Reggie White, number 92 here. Watch this play as Williams comes off the line of scrimmage, pushes him to the inside, away from Smith, opens up the huge hole, and then it's a patented run for Emmitt Smith.
And another good block Daryl Johnston put on George Koontz, the linebacker. Mentioned in the first half that last year in game two between Philadelphia and Dallas, Eric Williams was voted the offensive player of the week in the NFL, NFC. This pass low and short, intended for Novacek. It'll be second down.
I talked to Williams' offensive line coach, Hudson Houck, earlier in the week. And Hudson coached all those great offensive lines with the Los Angeles Rams. And he said that Williams reminds him of Jackie Slater, which is a pretty good comparison. Slater's played about 18 years in this league. They both have a perseverance and attention to detail, and they also have a nasty side to them. And by that he means they like to finish off their man.
Ultimately, I think the plan is to move Eric Williams from right tackle to left, but not until Mark Tuinen decides to retire. He's there now. Blitz again, fake the reverse, and Aikman is caught, and they whistle it dead. Bryce Pop, number 95. And that's a matter of how far back he went before the whistle blew. 8 yards is the answer.
And a good sportsmanship move there by Pop. A lot of times you see those guys come in on the quarterback and they'll throw him around like a rag doll. Well, Aikman's no rag doll, 230 pounds. And Pop did not risk getting the roughing the passer call there. That's a heads-up play.
Two sacks for the Packers today, third and 18, four-man front defensively. Aikman gets rid of it to Novacek. That will be short of the first down as Novacek is out of bounds at the 33-yard line. And that may also be at the periphery of Eddie Murray's range as a field goal kicker. They will bring him on to try it, though.
Aikman's going to come off the field here holding his right wrist, and you wonder why, because he landed on it there. Doesn't appear to be too severe. Actually, he's holding his left wrist and flexing his fingers. This is a 50-yarder for Murray.
Missed from 50 last week. He would have the length, and this time he's got the length again. Got it! Nice start for a young man who's been around this league for 14 years. Eddie Murray is 4 for 4, and the Cowboys lead by 12.
Karate chops across the wrist there, and it wasn't when he hit the ground, but he told everybody on the bench, leave me alone, I'm okay, I'm okay.
Eddie Murray will kick off. Corey Harris is in the locker room getting x-rays. That means Robert Brooks is on to take his place. He's got the ball at the three. It's up near the 23-yard line, and a flag is thrown at the 20. Tackle made by James Washington. Report from the Cowboy bench officially now, a bruised left elbow for Troy Aikman, but he is expected to return. And we have not gotten an update on Corey Harris from the Green Bay locker room. We'll wait that.
Holding, number 98 during the return, 10 yards, first down.
Billy Bates, free agent from Tennessee, doing what he's done for 11 years.
He was the first guy in the NFL that was voted to the Pro Bowl just on the strength of his special teams play. Now, that's what I consider contribution to the game of pro football.
A guy named John Madden fell in love with him and started promoting that idea. Bennett and West are in. Play action, Favre under some pressure from Maryland, lets it go for Sharp. And it is tipped by Kevin Smith. Well, great defense on both ends of that play. Russell Maryland draped all over Favre, and Kevin Smith draped all over Sharp.
And if Russell Maryland isn't in Favre's face, perhaps Favre can throw this ball maybe 1 or 2 yards further, and Smith doesn't make the play at the other end. But you see, Favre can't follow through, and the ball will just hang up there and allow Smith to come from nowhere and almost make the interception.
That brings up a second down and 10. Cowboys front. Favre is chased. Lets it go across the middle. And it's caught by Clayton. He's got the ball out near the 21 for a first down. That's a gain of 12. Mark Clayton, who plays with the patented sunglasses.
Well, the play before was Russell Maryland. Now it's going to be number 92, Tony Tolbert, here on the outside. Watch as he works an inside stunt here with Tony Casillas. Gets inside Joe Sims and forces Favre to throw on the run.
First and 10, Green Bay. Dallas leads at 19-7. We've got 11:33 to go, third quarter. Play action again. Favre has to let it go to Bennett, and he is tackled by Darren Smith for a loss at the 19. Oh, they're going to give him forward progress at the 21. Well, let's go back to New York and get an update from Greg Gumbel.
All right, Vern, we'll take you to Tampa, where Craig Erickson from 15 yards out finds Courtney Hawkins in the end zone in the third quarter. The Bucs looking for their first win of the year, pulled even with Detroit at 10 apiece. Vern and Dan, back to you.
Lions, of course, come into that game 3-1. The Cowboys in Green Bay in this one at 1-2. And now it's going to be second down and 10. Brett Favre, who is 17 of 27 for 145 yards. Blitz. Favre lets it go right side. For Darrell Thompson, it's overthrown. Incomplete. It'll be third down.
It's been real puzzling to me, and I'm sure a lot of Packer fans. What happens to the Packers after that opening drive? The last 3 weeks, the last three games, they've been able to score every time on their first drive, and then they don't do much of that after that. At least they haven't against Philly and Minnesota and Dallas. But maybe it's the pressure on the quarterback. You see there have been no sacks, but you look at this knockdowns and the hurries and all those things. Favre has had a lot of company in that backfield today.
Well, and they're down by 12 now, Dan. They've got to go almost exclusively to a passing game. I think they have 3 yards rushing in this game. Three. Here's Favre throwing right side for Sharp. Incomplete. Fourth down. John Stevens has carried 5 times for no yards. Bennett 5 for 7. Sharp 1 for -4. And they trail by 12. That is an enigma for Mike Holmgren and the bunch, though. They've scored almost at will in their opening drive.
Well, today they got the nice kickoff return, right, that opener by 42 yards by Thompson. But really, on offense, they haven't been able to generate anything after that.
Wagner, Kevin Williams. To the 43-yard line. 10 minutes and 22 seconds remaining in the third quarter of play. 19-7 Dallas, and they've got the football. Hard run by Edgar Bennett for Green Bay. A 61-yard pass catch by Michael Irvin for the Cowboys. The difference in the game, 4 Eddie Murray field goals. And Troy Aikman back after leaving for just a moment with an elbow injury. That to his left elbow. He's 10 of 12 in the ballgame. Matt Brock comes across. Did Nate Newton draw him across?
Brock's kind of hanging his head like he wishes that Nate had drawn him across. Don't think so.
Encroachment, number 62, defense, 5 yards, still first down.
Ooh, I saw a baseball score there.
I saw one by Colorado, but I think I saw a whole lot more next to Atlanta's score.
If 4 is more, that was that. There you go.
I knew I shouldn't have crossed Atlanta off the schedule there just yet.
Don't ever cross Jane Fonda. That's the key. First down and 5. Emmitt Smith. He wanted it stated plainly yesterday that he did not hold out. You hold out when you have a contract and don't report. His point being that he never had a contract. He said one of the things that really bothered him was when Ken Willis signed a free agent contract and left Dallas, a place kicker. And there was a lot of noise made here about loyalty to the organization. And that one incident disturbed him a lot and still does.
Yeah, loyalty is one of those things that kind of fits in wherever you want, especially if you're the guy that holds all the cards, and the owners usually do, and they get upset when a player goes away by way of free agency. And they say, well, he wasn't loyal to the organization. Well, Emmitt felt that what he has done in his career, he has played with all his contracts and is not held out. And he felt that he should have been rewarded for the loyalty he showed to Jerry Jones and this organization.
Got the first down on the last play. Now Aikman looks deep, fires it that way for Michael Irvin. Boy, they are really picking on these cornerbacks, Buckley and Mitchell. That's a 15-yard gain. And this time the victim is Mitchell.
And if all else fails, at the end of the play, you try to strip the ball or pop it away from the receiver. The timing here, though, is exquisite as we see Aikman let the ball go long before Irvin is out of his break. And now watch, here's the frustration of Mitchell trying to slap it loose. And all the help comes a little bit too late.
Toss, Smith at the 22-yard line. That's a gain of 9, and Emmitt Smith now has 50 yards in the game. Emmitt Smith also said he appreciated the effort of the rookie fourth-round draft choice, who was the focal point of so much venom by so many people in this area, Derek Lassick. Lassick, a fourth-round pick out of Alabama, but 187 yards, 3.8 yards per carry average. He got 2 touchdowns against Phoenix. And Smith made it a point to thank him for what he did during the protracted negotiations. Here's Johnson leading Smith. Touchdown, Emmitt Smith. And the number of yards equals the number on his back. 22 scores from 22. His mom and dad, by the way, are here to help him celebrate.
And they really provided the support and the backbone for him during the contract hassle with the Cowboys. And you know, everything's all forgotten now, as that looked like the Emmitt Smith that we saw lead the Cowboys to the Super Bowl last year.
Murray's extra point is up and good.
Cowboy fans didn't think they'd ever see this type of run again, but you know they're happy as Emmitt's in the end zone.
7:49 remaining, third quarter. Emmitt Smith's 22-yard touchdown run has given him 71 yards for the day, and the Cowboys a comfortable 26-7 lead. Eddie Murray's kick will be taken by Robert Brooks at the 5-yard line. Gets by Kevin Smith. Still loose. Still loose. Touchdown, Green Bay, Robert Brooks.
Cowboys thought he stepped out of bounds. They all stopped about the 30-yard line there. And Brooks just kept high-stepping down the sideline all the way in the end zone.
The Cheeseheads have reason to celebrate.
Well, the Cowboys fell asleep on the sidelines there. Looked like they were thinking that he was out of bounds and somebody was going to eventually push him out. Let's see how close he came. The wedge is perfect, and then great speed by Brooks getting to the outside. And somebody's got to push him out of bounds here. Everett gets one hand on him. But he doesn't go out there.
No.
He doesn't go out there. Murray doesn't do anything to push him out of bounds. And it's a touchdown for the Packers.
How interesting. We were talking with Corey Harris, who, by the way, is out and will not return, about the fact that he had never, ever returned to kickoff for a touchdown. And his substitute in that role, Robert Brooks, brings it back 95 yards.
But what was Eddie Murray thinking about? He had him. All he had to do was push him. He was probably thinking that Brooks would just step out of bounds. Unbelievable.
The last time the Packers returned to kickoff for a touchdown in 91, also against the Dallas Cowboys.
See Murray on the sideline saying, hey, I thought somebody would had him or that he was already out of bounds. But look, he's got the angle. Boy, Murray's got to get in the weight room and lift some weights there.
He didn't exactly enhance the kicker's reputation on special teams.
Boy, I tell you what, that's unbelievable. Kind of escorted him down the sidelines, pushed him towards the end zone and not out of bounds. We've seen some big plays on kickoffs today. Maybe that's a little payback for Murray. Remember the onside kick there earlier in the game? It's funny how these things go around and come back at you sometimes.
There's a picture of a man who has a 12-point lead and doesn't know it.
Well, Murray should go up to him and say, hey, but coach, I've already kicked 4 field goals for you.
And there's a picture of a man who will not let him forget it, Joe Avezzano.
Murray is not being paid to make tackles. We got to remember that. And I'm sure that he never will be paid for making tackles.
Here's Chris Jackie. That one goes out of bounds. We'll come out to the 35-yard line.
Well, let's take a look at a couple of plays back to this touchdown by Smith. Watch the block by Johnston and then the good teamwork by Stepnoski and Giesick as Reggie White takes the inside route, and now the final block by number 80 there, Alvin Harper, and that's why Emmett Smith goes 22 yards untouched for the touchdown.
And the Cowboys are back on offense, and Emmett Smith is going to give way to Derek Lassick.
You know, I saw him on the bench stretching that hamstring, and that was what Johnson were worried about. He has a history of hamstrings, especially those problems early in the season.
Aikman back, lets it go for Lassick as George Kuntz was coming on the blitz and was right at his knees.
This is only a 12-point game here, and the Packers, of course, aren't going to quit. Watch Kuntz take it right up the middle here on the blitz, and you're not going to get any better run at the quarterback than that. Aikman just unloaded it.
7:20 remaining, third quarter. Tampa has taken a lead over Detroit, and Chicago continues to lead over Atlanta. Our second game coming up. Here's the handoff to Lassick, and the Cowboys' fourth-round draft choice from Alabama moves it out to the 38-yard line.
I thought it was interesting when we talked to Johnson yesterday, and we, you know, hashed over the Emmett Smith situation and everything, and I asked him, were there any positive things that came out of the holdout, or not the holdout, but the contract hassles? And he said, took him a while. And he said, yeah, it was a positive thing. It was that Derek Lassick proved to me and proved to this ball club that he can play in this league.
Lassick is in there now. Third down. Nope, it's Gaynor. Flags are down.
Looks like Aikman used the hard count to pull Bryce Pop into the neutral zone and offsides.
Encroachment. Number 95 defense, 5 yards, still third down.
Atlanta continues to lead Colorado, top of the sixth.
You know, I can fix this. I can put another number there. That'd be 11-4, wouldn't it?
Only if the guys in the truck choose to let you put it on the screen. See, ultimately, we are never in control.
No. We've never been accused of that.
Aikman, Novacek. First down, Dallas. George Kuntz with the tackle.
Now, as an inside linebacker, you've got a dilemma as to what to do here. You got to play the run, but now every once in a while, you're called upon to make a tackle in the passing game. Kuntz had Novacek man-to-man, and Novacek got the good start and a good pass from his quarterback, picked up the first down.
5:45 remaining, third quarter, 26-14 Dallas. Aikman play action. Settles for the short man, that's Novacek at the 50-yard line, and Bryce Pop is there, and then Leroy Bunker comes up to help. That's a gain of 6. Mentioned a moment ago the doubleheader coming up. Many of you will see Philadelphia and the New York Jets Others will watch Minnesota at San Francisco, and then New Orleans, undefeated so far, goes west to take on the Rams, who were 2-2. Is there any team that surprised you early in the season more than another?
I think Philadelphia. When you saw all those free agents leave and guys bailing out of that situation, everybody said they weren't going to be very good. Off to another good start, though.
Second and four, and Michael Irvin makes the catch in front of Roland Mitchell again. That's a gain of 14, and Michael Irvin now has six catches for 138 yards.
Well, the key is his strength. Watch him just push off with that left hand just enough to get the separation from Mitchell, who had tight coverage, but the size difference and the strength of Michael Irvin made that play.
First down at the 34-yard line. Look at the figures for Michael Irvin. And 61 of those yards came on a touchdown that tied it up 7-7 early. Blitz coming. Aikman gets a good block from Lassie, but then the ball is almost picked off by Terrell Buckley.
That's twice now that a big play has happened to the Packers when both of their defensive backs have run into each other. Butler gives good pressure. Lassick makes a wonderful block. Watch number 25 pick up this blitz right there. But now Buckley's going to make this interception, and Pryor's going to come over there. And Buckley can't get back to the rebound.
Terrell Buckley victimized on the long pass from McMahon to Gulliford last week. Second down and 10. Here's the toss, left side. Johnny Holland, who played collegiately in this state at Texas A&M, made the tackle. Well, let's see what's going on elsewhere in the league. Back to New York, here's Greg Gumbel.
All right, Vern, it's what's happening in Tampa. Reggie Cobb, 3-yard run around the left side, puts the Bucs on top, 17-10. Eric Kramer has now replaced Andre Ware at quarterback for the Lions as the Bucs chase win number one of the year, Vern.
Now, you talk about a quarterback rotation. What's going on in Detroit?
Somebody upstairs said, I want to play that guy that won the Heisman Trophy. And he's not getting it done. And poor Eric Kramer, he keeps getting thrown in the mix.
Blitz again, third and six. They hand it off to Derek Gaynor, number 39. And he is cut down at the 30-yard line. And we're going to see Eddie Murray. This falls right into the pattern of things that have been going on this year in the league. Field goal after field goal after field goal. Ad nauseum.
Well, Murray really needs to make this kick to make everybody forget his tackling ability.
He's 4 for 4 thus far. That's the difference in the ball game. This from 48 yards. He's hit from 50. Novacek will hold. Perfect. He's gone from 37 to 35. Losing ears. Eddie Murray with 5, 29-14, Dallas.
He who hesitates is going to get hit right in the face. Watch the hesitation here by Brooks bringing out a little bit too late. He's too far from his wedge right now. The hole will open up only to be closed by Smith up high and Gant down low. There's Gant coming off the turf.
Kenneth Gant, star of the special teams. Bill Bates was the first big star of these special teams. Kenneth Gant is another. Here's Favre into the flat for Thompson. Well, they are throwing the ball because they're down by 15 and they have not been able to run today. Look at the number of rushing yards for the Green Bay Packers.
And if this holds up, you know it's going to be an all-time record for both teams. For futility for Green Bay and for stopping the run for Dallas.
Thompson and Stevens are in the backfield, or rather Bennett in the backfield now. John Stevens, 5 carries for no yards. And here's Tony Talbert taking care of Edgar Bennett. And it will be third down following the loss. Ken Norton and Frank Winters along with James Campen engaging in a little conversation.
Yeah, the Packers started off the game throwing the ball and having success doing it. They never quite established anything on the ground in the first half as they did last week against the Vikings. It's almost like a catch-22 situation for Holmgren. Damned if he does, damned if he doesn't. Offense is just not clicking.
Third and 11. 29-14. Screen pass. Edgar Bennett. James Washington and Bill Bates. Fourth down.
Yeah, Bennett had two blockers out in front. Both blockers threw their blocks and both of them missed. And that left Bennett with absolutely nothing.
Kevin Williams back to return it at the 30-yard line. And Brian Wagner on the punt. Returnable. Oh, fair catch. So the Cowboys take over with a first down and 10 at the 42-yard line. And they're up by 15 points, 29-14. In 1967, Green Bay, Wisconsin, the operator called my room and said, it's 15 degrees below zero. The Cowboys and the Packers. One of the most famous games ever, the Ice Bowl. And one of the most, trust me, it was 21-17.
Well, you were there.
Yes.
Were you cold?
I was standing behind Frank Gifford and watched his coffee freeze. And the carry out to the 46. Well, you know, that Dan was such a famous game. And look at what's happened to the respective franchises since that game was played. The Cowboys, of course, became next year's champions, but they later went on and appeared in six Super Bowls, 18 playoff years, 20 winning years, and it has not been that good for Green Bay.
You got to give Tom Landry a lot of credit for bouncing back and having his team bounce back. And Jimmy Johnson now has taken over, got the Cowboys in the Super Bowl again.
Aikman back, goes deep right side. Double coverage, and Buckley is back there with good coverage on Alvin Harper. Darrell Buckley.
That was a good job of Harper not giving up on the ball. Great coverage by Buckley, but Harper knocked the ball away at the last moment and kept Buckley from making the interception. Let's take a look at the end of it. Watch Harper stick his right hand out here. If he doesn't do that, Buckley makes the grab easily. As it was, Buckley almost got the rebound.
It'll be third down and five. 29-14, 37 seconds to go, third quarter. Aikman across the middle for Novacek. First down at the 45. Leroy Butler, number 36, makes the tackle, a gain of eight. And that might be the last play of the third quarter. Cowboys had a bye week last week, of course, after they defeated Phoenix. How do these guys celebrate a bye? Well, Troy Aikman went to a country western concert.
I wonder why. Big country western fan?
Yeah. Lori Morgan was performing in Atlanta. That's the end of three with the score, 29-14 Dallas. Our coverage continues after this message from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Back for the start of the final quarter at Texas Stadium in Irving, when the Cowboys trying to even their record at 2-2. So are the Green Bay Packers, but Dallas has the upper hand, a 29-14 lead and a first down at the Green Bay 45. Aikman, 15 of 20 for 217 yards. Hands it off to Derek Lassick. And the fourth round draft choice from Alabama gets down to the 42-yard line. It will be second down. I would think we've probably seen all of Emmitt Smith for the day.
I think it was important for him to come out in the second half and get a positive performance. That 22-yard touchdown was a nice way of capping off his afternoon. But remember, this is only his second game, so you got to be a little bit careful with him as far as potential muscle pulls. And I think he might have felt his right hamstring twinge just a bit.
Blitz, Aikman reads it, goes to the left side and finds one of his big receivers, Michael Irvin. 17-yard gain. That's seven catches and puts Irvin over 150 yards for the day.
Aikman has such confidence in Irvin, and he's getting that same type of confidence with Harper on the other side. Again, throwing the ball early, anticipating the break of the receiver, and knowing that with Irvin's desire and size and strength, he's going to make another grab.
First down, blitz coming. Lassick goes left. Johnson tries to help him out with the block, and Tuane does as well. And it's a pickup of just a couple.
It's amazing, though, with Smith coming back and signing and the Cowboys having the bye week and everything. Asked Johnson about the attitude of the ball club and how positive was it. He said, well, it's like we're 3-0. I know we're only 1-2, but we feel like we're 3-0. We feel good. Everything's right in the world, you know. We're going to be 2-2 real soon.
Second and nine. Left side, Novacek. First down at the 11. And a gain of 13. Boy, it's been a precision-like passing attack with an occasional deep ball by the Dallas Cowboys.
It's all pass protection, too, Vern. Watch Darrell Johnston here. He's going to help out Eric Williams and just take Reggie by one shoulder. That slows him up enough. And there's just nobody around the quarterback. That's why Aikman is just passed over for 307 yards or something like that. I'm so excited. I love those 300-yard passing games.
Here's a hanky cleanup.
Hey, Madden can slobber.
Aikman being chased by Reggie White. Fires it for Bruce Johnson at the one. The moose is loose.
And I'm okay too, Vern. Here's Aikman on the rollout. And Reggie's really got him here, but I think he underestimated Troy's mobility. But nobody will underestimate his arm strength. Throwing on the run here, against his body, finds the moose at about the five, and he takes it all the way to the one.
10 on the last play, first and goal, Dallas. It's Lassick and Johnson behind Aikman. It'll be Lassick. No touchdown indication. Here it comes. He gets his third touchdown in a Cowboy uniform.
And he already knows what to do with the football. Take it over to the sidelines and give it to the equipment man, Mr. Buchanan. He's going to paint it up for him, put it on the mantle.
Buck Buchanan has been the equipment manager for the Dallas Cowboys since 1973. And ultimately, Lassick will give him the ball.
He's looking for him, too. Somebody take the ball. The assistant equipment guy gets it.
Right.
He's only a rookie.
Murray. Extra point is good.
The most potent offense in football. They can bring a rookie off the bench to replace Emmitt Smith. The results are pretty much the same.
Favre comes back in, his team now trailing by a bundle, 36-14.
Talked about offensive touches and how many opportunities each player will get. Pretty good balance all the way down the line for the Cowboys. And for the Packers, this is just too much here for the fullback, Bennett.
First down and 10. Backs are split. John Stevens has been on the bench for this half. Thompson has taken his place. Here's the sweep with Thompson. Frank Winters in front. And that will almost, well, that will more than double or almost double the previous number of yards the Packers had picked up on the ground. That was a gain of 11. They had six, so they just about doubled it.
In the National League Baseball,
it'll be first and 10. 36-14, 10-55 remaining in the game. Brett Favre slides down at the 41-yard line. They might give him the 42.
Favre grew up being a big Cowboy fan and a big fan of number 12, Roger Staubach. Did a Staubach imitation that time.
Hey, Staubach, one of those whose name one finds in the Ring of Honor here, the newest inductee to the Ring of Honor. Ends a turbulent relationship between Tom Landry and the current ownership. Landry will be inducted into the Ring of Honor November 7th when his former team, the Giants, play here against the Cowboys. Ball is out to the 45-yard line. Whoops. 4-3 Atlanta over Colorado.
And then still in the top of the seventh with the Rockies batting.
Go Rockies, huh, Dan? And of course, later this afternoon, the Giants play the Dodgers in baseball. If both Atlanta and San Francisco win, there's a one-game playoff tomorrow night. And of course, the league championship series began Tuesday on CBS with Toronto at Chicago. That's Tuesday night. Favre across the middle. And the catch is made at the 49-yard line. Ken Norton and Dixon Edwards make the tackle.
Now here the Packers are trailing by 22 yards and they're still not going down the field with the passing game. You got 9 minutes to go. You got nothing to lose. You got to start going for the home run for the touchdowns.
Second down from the 50. Second and six. Favre is 18 of 31, but a modest 151 yards. Jackie Harris makes the grab at the 42. That's a first down. Well, the Packers do go back home next week. They take on Denver. Mike Holmgren's team, he said last week was so disappointing to him, and he was angry all week long about the way they lost. He finally on Wednesday called his former boss and mentor, Bill Walsh, at Stanford. And they had a chat, and Walsh tried to give him a little philosophy to live by to get through the loss, and it didn't help much. Here's Thompson going right. Well, we showed you the score. Let's see what's happening visually. Here's Greg Gumbel again on baseball. That is not Greg Gumbel. That is Darrell Thompson. And we'll get to the baseball update as soon as we can. That's Emmett Smith. Second and seven. 36-14, 7:43 to go. Favre finds Ed West, his tight end. That's another first down at the 30-yard line. Now let's try a second time. Back to New York. Here's Greg.
All right, Vern, we'll try it and make it good this time. Tom Glavine delivers to Roberto Mejia. Solo home run into right center field. That cuts Atlanta's lead to 4-3. They're in the top of the seventh. Glavine is out of the game for Atlanta, trying to gain a share of first in the National League West today, Vern.
All right, Greg, 36-14 in the football game here. Dallas over Green Bay, and the Packers have a first down and 10. Favre is back. Screen pass left side that's a little too high for Edgar Bennett.
Yeah, the Packers are still looking for that magical win number 500 in their history. Looking at Fort for a few weeks now. It's not going to get much easier. You mentioned the fact that they have to play Denver next week at home. They do have a bye, and they're getting some help from their next opponent after that, Tampa, today. They're beating the Lions. So you expect this race, as it seems like every year in the NFC Central, to be like a 9-7, 10-6. But the problem is that only one team seems to make it into the playoffs because of those records.
Here's Favre, pumps once, goes deep, mix up on the pass pattern. And it's incomplete. Robert Brooks took a post route. Brett Favre threw it for the corner. I think he was trying to come back for it.
And I'm not so sure that shouldn't be been called illegal contact by Larry Brown. It was a slant and go move by Brooks. And after the slant move, Brown chucked him well beyond the 5 yards down the field. Watch at the bottom of the screen. Brooks is going to come in and then out. And now watch the contact right there. That's illegal contact. What are the officials looking at?
Not that one. Here's the blitz. Favre across the middle, tipped by Bates. Incomplete. Billy Bates, who had very serious knee surgery last year. Many thought he'd never play again. He came back, and this summer, in his 30s, and he was never fast, ran the fastest 40 time he'd ever posted.
He ran a 4.5. He told me that he worked 9 hours a day, 7 days a week, pointing for training camp in that time when they would time him in the 40 and also lift weights. He says, that was my Olympics, the training camp, and he has proven that he can still contribute coming back from that devastating knee injury and be a big part of this team.
On fourth down, Favre chased by Jeffco. Well, you've just seen back-to-back plays by two of the oldest Cowboys. Jim Jeffco, the number one draft choice of this team in 1983, and Billy Bates, a free agent on this team in 1983.
And a youngster who is 7 days away from his 24th birthday, going through some of the growing pains of being a starting quarterback in the NFL.
Loss of 22 Cowboys ball.
And by Ally Signals, Autolite spark plugs guaranteed for 2 years no matter how far you go.
Cowboys have Jason Garrett in at quarterback, Troy Aikman done for the day. And here's a one-time Princeton quarterback handing off to Derek Lassick. Jason Garrett, who spent last year on the practice squad for the Cowboys, he participated with San Antonio in the World League, played collegiately with his brother Judd at Princeton. Their dad is a coach and a former coach and now a Cowboy scout. He was thought to be a prospect for the third team quarterback spot this year, but played so well in preseason that he beat out Hugh Millen, who was signed for a lot of money as a backup out of New England. Jason Garrett, 2 for 4 for the season. May not get a chance to throw today. Here's Lassick. Cowboys will work on the clock, and Lassick is triple teamed. Well, let's keep you posted on what's happening in Atlanta with baseball. Once again, here's Greg.
All right, Vern, just like that, things have switched around. Gary Wayne on the mound for the Rockies. David Justice swings and delivers home run number 40 of the season, and it's a two-run lead for Atlanta again. 5-3 in the seventh inning. They're still hitting in there. Tomahawk chopping away in Atlanta, Vern.
Mr. Gumbel, you're breaking my partner's heart.
Yeah, quit bringing up those Atlanta highlights here. If I'm going to root for the Giants, I don't want to see that. I've been a Rockies fan for years.
Yes, you have, or at least since April. Third down. Here's Garrett trying to come right. Gogan provides him with a block, and he passes it to Michael Irvin, who's made a ton of grabs today. It's Tyrone Williams, I beg your pardon, number 86.
That's the big bird at 6'5". He's bigger than Harper and Williams.
Well, here's the offensive line of the Green Bay Packers. Ken Rutgers in the middle of the bunch. Been a very long day. And on fourth down, here is John Jett to punt for the first time this afternoon. Buckley is back to return it. Nice and high. Fair catch called by Buckley. Makes the grab at the 18. He's had fumble problems like Kevin Williams has. Dropped one last week. There's also a flag down back at the line of scrimmage. Reggie White in the middle of that picture.
And you know he would like to see number 90 return to the Green Bay defense. Tony Bennett takes some of that heat off of Reggie. And Bennett can provide it.
Here's Tom Hoyt.
Holding number 40 on the kicking team. 10 yards, still fourth down.
Holding call is on Bill Bates. Just to update you on the Tony Bennett story, if you missed the NFL today, he was on with Greg and Terry and said that there had been nothing new this week or late this week. And of course, Ron Wolf told us last week that he expected a long, drawn-out procedure. He didn't look forward to Bennett getting back in uniform quickly. Here's Jett. And Buckley will let this one go. And it's going to drop and be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line. 53-yard punt. And a new quarterback coming on for the Green Bay Packers, Ty Detmer.
Coca-Cola presents the All-Monster Team. This running back is known as Lone Star Sheriff. Find out why after this.
Coca-Cola presents Monsters of the Gridiron.
Isn't that Randall Cunningham?
Not for long.
Play Coca-Cola's Monsters of the Gridiron. Grab a specially marked Coke, call the toll-free Sprint Monster line, punch in the monster code, and turn an NFL player into a monster.
Rocket Man?
Your monster will tell you if you've won Super Bowl tickets, NFL merchandise, and Coca-Cola products.
That's Lawrence Taylor.
Give me the phone.
Always Coca-Cola.
Emmett Lone Star Sheriff Smith is a running back on the All-Monster Team. He earned his star riding the football range for the world champion Dallas Cowboys. Last season's rushing champion, Smith keeps defenders guessing and always settles the score.
It is an entirely new class of luxury automobile, created to a higher standard. So responsive, its advanced V8 Northstar system makes passing and merging virtually effortless. And so spacious, it accommodates 6 passengers in complete comfort. It is a combination of qualities you've never seen before. Yet a single drive will make you wonder why you ever settled for less. Introducing the all-new DeVille Concours by Cadillac, creating a higher standard.
I want to fly like an eagle to the sea. Fly like an eagle, let my spirit carry me. I want to fly like an eagle, going free. Fly through the revolution.
Eagles and Jets lead off the second half of our doubleheader. Others of you will see Minnesota and the 49ers or New Orleans and the Rams. Ty Detmer is in the quarterback now. The Heisman Trophy winner at Brigham Young, and he hands it off to Darrell Thompson, who goes right across the 10 and into the arms of John Roper. Here's Ty Detmer in his second year with the Packers. Played high school ball 200 miles south of here in San Antonio, Texas.
You talked about how Jason Garrett beat out Hugh Millen for the second job. Well, Detmer beat out a pretty formidable quarterback this summer, Ken O'Brien, for the second quarterback job.
And it's a second down and 5. Detmer back to throw across the middle, caught. And that's close for the first down yardage. Brett Favre, who winds up today with 173 yards on 21 of 37. Beginning the day, here's the way the picture looked in the Central.
Yeah, it looks like Detroit's going to go to 2 losses there. Minnesota's later. Chicago, they're on top, so we'll give them 2 wins. Bad for Green Bay, though. And Tampa's going to get off the schneid and get their first win of the 93 season. So it's going to be that way all year long. It is that way, it seems like, every year. Surprising, though, that Detroit falls to a team that was winless before today.
Prior to today, and if they do wind up losing, the only Lion loss was on the road at New Orleans. There's the update, 24-10. Reggie Cobb with 109 yards. Chicago continues to lead. Billy Joe Tolliver has taken Bobby Hebert's place. Montana pulled a hamstring and left that game, and Kansas City rolling over the Raiders.
That will really change, though, the complexion of the AFC West if Montana is out for any length of time.
Michael Irvin, 7 catches, 155 yards today. Packers try the middle on 3rd and 1, and we'll see if they got the first down. Reggie White, his team winners in his first game in Green Bay, 36-6. Well, this one won't have the impact emotionally that the last two had, the last-minute losses to Minnesota and to Philadelphia. This game is presented by Authority, the National Football League, and this CBS telecast is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the expressed written consent of CBS, the Dallas Cowboys, and the National Football League is prohibited. First and 10, Detmer back. Comes left side, caught by Robert Brooks all the way out to the 42-yard line. In front of Larry Brown, that's another first down as we reach the three-minute mark.
That the Packers knew that they were in trouble today, though, with the Cowboys having a bye last week, and then, of course, the emotional uplift they received with Emmitt Smith signing before the Phoenix game. All the talk was that the Cowboys were back to being how they felt at the end of last year when they won the Super Bowl.
Well, what's your sense of where Dallas is? We'll get to that after the first down 10 play as Detmer is back to throw again. He goes deep right side, man-for-man coverage from Kevin Smith, and the ball is incomplete, intended for Sterling Sharp.
I think the Cowboys right now are the best team in the NFL. Even though they're only 2-2, they're healthy. On offense, they've got Aikman, who is just red hot. 2 weeks in a row now, he's been well over 75% in completions, at 300 yards passing today. And you see they got a tough schedule, though, coming up, especially with San Francisco, Philly, and the Giants. But the health of their team, they're both mentally and physically, is just top-notch.
Second and 10. Screen pass. Thompson tackled. Kenneth Gant. That's a loss of three. How about Troy Aikman's day? 18 of 23 for 317 yards. And that's on the heels of the 21 of 27 day last week, or 2 weeks ago. We have reached the two-minute warning. The Cowboys will win it. They lead 36-14.
This Camel system is so adaptive, it can travel 50 miles in desert heat without taking fluid, making it one of the world's most dependable animals. This automobile system is so adaptive that if necessary for your safety, it is engineered to travel 50 miles in desert heat without a single drop of coolant, which might also tell you something about its dependability. The Seville STS with the North Star system by Cadillac, creating a higher standard.
Years ago, when people wanted to send us a letter, all they had to do was write Coors, Golden, Colorado on the envelope. That'll still work today. So if you want to drop us a line about beer or baseball or whatever, it'll get here. Honest.
In the year 2032, in a peaceful world, two mortal enemies from another time will be unleashed.
I've been dreaming about killing you for 40 years. Keep dreaming.
Sylvester Stallone, Wesley Snipes, Demolition Man. Rated R. Starts Friday, October 8th.
For this guy, any deodorant will do. But these guys need Speed Stick. Antiperspirant that gives 110%. And now Speed Stick deodorant has a powerful new formula to fight odor. Speed Stick. For movers and shakers, the number one. The only one.
Coming up Tuesday night, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, with the first pitch scheduled at 8:12 Eastern Time. The Toronto Blue Jays take on the Chicago White Sox. Then on Wednesday, Game 1 of the National League Championship Series. It'll be either the Giants or the Braves at Philadelphia Wednesday night at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. That's the artistry of my partner, Mr. Fouts, who grew up in the Bay Area, and as you may have gathered throughout the afternoon, a rather ardent Giant fan.
On one knee, too.
Third Big down. Boy, I really look forward to going down and doing the Atlanta Falcons and the reception you'll get in the Southeast if we go down there.
Well, they'll be chopping at me, I know that.
Fourth down, and Brian Wagner's on to punt. Kevin Williams back to return it. Cowboys will go to 2-2 and go on the road at Indianapolis, then back here against the 49ers in 2 weeks. Here's Wagner's punt. Nice and high, and chases Williams all the way back inside the 10. At the 7. Bates provides a block. Williams breaks it out to the 25-yard line. Tackle was made by Dexter McNabb. 1:42 remaining in regulation, 36-14, Dallas.
The players that played for so many years and played so well for each organization.
Mike Holmgren's team is going to go 1-3. Jimmy Johnson's is going to go 2-2. The Cowboys at Indianapolis next, and the Green Bay Packers back home against Denver next Sunday night. Our game today produced by Michael Burks and directed by Andy J. Kindle. The coordinating producer of the NFL Today is Eric Mann. Directed by Larry Cavallino. The senior producer of the NFL on CBS is Ed Gorin. And the executive in charge of production is Rick Gentile. Jimmy Johnson and Mike Holmgren, the Cowboys win it. Eddie Murray with 5 field goals. Bill Bates with a couple of special teams tackles. So for Dan Fouts, I'm Vern Lundquist saying so long from Dallas, where our final score was the Cowboys winning at 36-14. Coming up next on CBS Sports, game 2 of our doubleheader, you'll see one of these games. The Vikings are at San Francisco, the undefeated New Orleans Saints take on the Rams, or the Philadelphia Eagles at the New York Jets. We'll also be back with Greg and Terry in our New York studios with a bit of a postgame show. CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League continues after these words from your local station.